Hello dear students, welcome back to Chemistry class. Today we are going to start our next topic, that is reactive formula from the name of given coordination compound. It is part 8. What is topic is formulas of molecular coordination entities. Formulas of mono nuclear coordination entities coordination entities. Okay. Before this, we have discussed how to write the name of RBC. Here we will see how to write the formula from RBC name of coordination compound. Formula of coordination compound. So we will start, we will follow some steps. What are the steps? We will discuss here and then we will go through some examples. Here, first in this formula, that first we have to write the name of central metal atom. What is name of central metal atom? We will write name of central metal atom. Second is atom name. Central metal atom. We will write first name of central metal atom. Second is that then ligands name. Ligands in alphabetical order. Okay. And in ligand, if ligand is amidantate, so in bracket we will write the number. We will write in bracket. Okay. By showing that, like that, if we are writing in name, it is given nitrite to in bracket it is N and it means here we have to write NO2 like this. What is it then? Nitrite to O, then we will write O and O. And like this, ligand name will be written in the bracket. Like this bracket we will put here. Okay. Then the formula of coordination entity will be closed in square bracket like this. We will use here. Fourth is charge charge is balanced. Charge is balanced. By giving charge to coordination entity or by writing appropriate number of ion number of counter ion. Last point, there should not be space between central metal atom and ligands. There should not be space between central metal atom and ligands. And last point is this: to show number of ligands. So number of ligands. Number to select them. So it will be more clear if we are taking some example. Okay, this is our first step. Okay, so if I am taking examples from your book, it will be more clear. So let us move to exercise of your book. From there things will be clear. Okay, so by that we will solve the exercise and you should solve the exercise of this chapter. So I am taking question number 9.6. What is question number 9.6? So first I will write here and later we will do it. Okay. So first is like this. What is that? Is tetrahydroxo zincate. First is tetrahydroxo zincate. Second. This is the name of compound. What we have to do? We have to write the formula. So what I told, first we will write the central metal. So here it is zincate. This zinc is central metal atom. You know that? Zinc. We will write the zinc. Okay. Then ligand same. So how many are there? Tetra. Tetra means 4. Okay. And hydroxo. Hydroxo. Yes. Hydroxo means OH. Okay. So we will write in bracket OH. How many? 4. Tetrahydroxo. Okay. and here we will close it in a square bracket, and this is coordination entity becomes. Now we have to balance the charge. Here oxidation state is second, but one point is remember, it is zincate. This zincate. So when we wrote the name, I told one thing. If coordination entity carrying negative charge, then 8 will be added. It is normally zinc. So 8 is added, means here there is negative charge. That's what this I think. But how many negative charges is there? Not confirmed. Okay. Here 2 is left. Means oxidation state of zinc is 2. So one thing we can do, we can write directly weaker, but if we have not ability to write like that, so we can do like that. Here we can do one thing. Here minus 4 equal, here just to see -4, and we have to change it in 2. So if we wrote minus 2, so if we are transferring here, so plus 4 and minus 2 equal 2. Understand this? So there we have to give 2 minus. This is the formula. Okay, students, you do it. Maybe confusion. So if you are solving, things will be clear. Second is, what is second? Second compound is here potassium. Second is potassium here tetrachloride pyridate. Second potassium, just to see after that gap is given in your book, it is given tetrafluoride or fluoride pyridate second. Just to see one word. Maybe confusion? Yes, sure. So just you see in your book also, here in your book it is given this second one, potassium tetrachloride pyridate second, means if gap is there means here it is gap. So that shows coordination entity means this will be written in square bracket, understand? And this showing counter ion. Remember it. Counter ion. This showing counter ion, and that show coordination entity. Okay? So let us see here. And we will write just to see. I think it is clear. Is it clear? If gap is there, means first, what is written, it will show counter ion, and that no gap showing coordination entity. So first we will write this name, means positive portion name here. Okay, so potassium, I am writing potassium. Okay, potassium, I told that is in coordination entity, so I will write in square bracket. I think it is here. Palladium is, what is central metal? Which one? Pd. Pd is central atom. How many chloride or chloride is there? 4. And chloride is there. How chloride is there? And how many are there? 4. Okay. That is 4. And now they will close the square bracket or coordination entity. Now problem is that we have to balance the charge. We have to balance the charge. So just you see, oxidation state is 2 here. Oxidation state is 2. So if I wrote 2 here, it is balanced. Okay. If doubt is there, again doubt is there. From this to write I have question name of this. So what will be the question name of this? If excited sum in, that is correct. What is potassium? Just to write potassium. You know that potassium tetra chloride palladate. Here may be confusion about oxidation state. So we can calculate also. Let the oxidation state of this is x plus 4 into minus 1. Here what will be? It is counter ion. So we can write like this also, plus 2 plus 1 equals 0. Okay. So x minus 4 plus 2 equals 0. X minus 2 equals 0. X equals plus 2. Like this we can write. Understand this? So what is the oxidation state? Oxidation state may be confusing to write oxidation state, but we have to balance it. Okay, students. So little bit careness is needed. Here like this. Once if you are writing the formula from the given name, first write formula and how to check it is correct or incorrect. So what we have to do, from the formula again if we are writing the name of that compound is same as, so we can say we have written correct formula. Here one more time I would like to revise it. Here if gap is between that, if we have written like this name is given, so it shows counter ion. Being positive, we will write first counter ion. First we will write counter ion. Okay, then I wrote counter ion here, and that shows the coordination. If there is no gap, that shows coordination entity. So that will be written in square bracket. So after that I put square bracket, and first we will write central metal atom. Central metal atom is palladium, PD. We have written PD. How many chloride are there? So a ligand is chloride. So ligand is chloride. How many are there? 4. Cl and 4. Okay, every reaction I have written how many are there. Okay, like this we can solve. So more example we will see. So next example I have taken here. Hexamine cobalt third sulfate. Hexamine cobalt third sulfate. Means you might have seen here that here there is a gap. There is after third there is gap. It means that shows counter ion. Okay. And this shows coordination entity. I think it is clear. Here we can see coordination entity. This is coordination entity. And we will write first coordination entity, or if you are getting more point. So this is positive portion, that is negative portion. This is positive portion, that is negative portion. So first we will write positive portion. So what is hexaamine cobalt? So it is coordination entity is written in what is square bracket. How many cobalt is center metal atom? I wrote cobalt. How many are amine? Hexaamine. So I will write NH3. And how many are there? 6. Understood this? I think it is clear. Hexaamine cobalt third. Okay, so we can write sulfate here, just it is completed here, and we can write sulfate SO4 sulfate. So I think name is clear. So to clear it we can write the abbreviation name from this. So what will be? Hexa hexaamine cobalt third, are you sure? Sulfate. So like this we can write the name of the given compound. Okay students, let us see here. I wrote this oxidation state can be calculated, can be balanced. Okay, it depends on you, how do you calculate, how do you balance it. Okay, so we have written it. Next and last example. So I have taken another example. Example is potassium trioxalate chromate. Okay, so you will see there what is. You see potassium. Some gap is there. Yes. Trioxalate chromate means this shows outer ion and that shows coordination activity. Now clear? So we can write the formula by using this detail. So let us see here. Let me write first. We always write positive portion first. So potassium K. Okay. In that coordination entity, we don't know how many potassiums are there. So we will write like that. Chromate means chromium is there. Chromium is there. Trioxalate. Oxalate is bidentate. Oxalate is bidentate or didentate, we can say. So sometimes we write coax also. Our formula of that is oxalate C2O4 double minus. Okay, that can be written. I can write this also, or that can be written, that also can be written. How many are there? That is 3. Now we can close the coordination entity or square bracket. Now problem is that how to balance the charge. So you know that it is didentate. What is didentate or bidentate? So 3 is there, means oxidation state is, means how many charges there will be? 6. And we have to make 3. So if 6 is there and it is positive, 6 minus is there and we have to make 3. We have to make 3. So what we can do, we can subtract 3 from that. 3 positive we are subtracting, so that will be, I think you understood. Here we can calculate also, is it correct? So let the oxidation state of that is x, and for that how many are 3 and minus 2 here plus, okay, 3 plus 1 equals 0. So x here, I am calculating here x plus minus 6 plus 3 equals 0. We can remove bracket. X minus 6 plus 3 equals 0. X minus 3 equals 0. X equals plus 3. This is oxidation. So like guys, we can calculate. One more thing I told. From this, to write the abbreviation name of the compound. So what will be, just we can write abbreviation name, potassium potassium, okay, then we will give some gap, trioxalate chromate acromate third. So both are same as, so on this basis we can say we have written correct formula of given coordination name. Okay students, so today I am going to finish here. So later we can discuss some more examples, otherwise it is better. Some examples are remaining, so from that you write the formula and match. How to check formula is correct or incorrect? First, from formula, from name you write formula, and from formula you write name. We both is matching, so you have written correct. Okay students, so keep watching my videos and like and share it if you want. Okay students, thank you so much.